Jaymi laughs out loud. Yes, of course, he's welcome to come over. He is, after all, the embodiment of my own blonde seriousness of mind, despite my not even being blonde. In fact, what am I saying? Kim even lives there on Electra Drive, with Shigem and Evelyn in the guest wing, so he'll already be around when you arrive. Though I am careful to allow the three of them their privacy, so I don't tend to go knocking on the guest wing door to visit them. Oh, what an absurdly exciting but cosy arrangement that sounds like, bubbles Ashley, emitting a high-strung, frisky giggle down the phone line. Well, yeah, you know, we muddle through, says Jaymi. Then without warning, he becomes aware that he's blushing, just as Shigem and he so prominently blushed throughout their teens, almost every time another person stared at them. But this time he's alone, at the bottom of this furthest flight of steps down and out into the untamed canyon, sitting by himself, while his cheeks burn hot and pink and bright beyond control. Okay then, see you tomorrow night, says Ashley. Great, let's say 8:30. Give me a call from outside the gates and I'll let you in. He terminates the call, then punches the air in triumphal satisfaction, proclaiming aloud to himself, yay, 2 dreary ones converted, 2 to go, ace. Subsiding from this vocal bravado, he puts the phone away. His gaze melts into the distant haze of the city. He raises both hands to his face, and with the lightest of pressure, he lays his fingers against both his cheeks, barely touching the skin. And through all 8 fingertips, he can feel the relentless, lifelong throb of Shigem's teenage vulnerability, pressing pink and warm and shy just beneath the surface.